here and welcome back to my channel. This is the channel where we talk all about, well, handbags pretty much, as you can tell from my background and the title of this video. That's kind of like my thing. So if you are interested in that as well, please have a look around my channel and hit the subscribe button. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about something a little bit different, and that is going to be my handbag pet peeves. Now, these are the things that really, really bother me in a handbag, and if I'm deciding, you know, whether or not to purchase something, if the handbag has one of these qualities, it's probably gonna, you know, maybe deter me from them a little bit, but definitely if it has, you know, two or more of these qualities, it's a definite no from me. So I thought that would be interesting to share with you guys today, and yeah, let's just get started with the list. All right, so the number one thing, and I think you guys have heard me talk about this a million times if you watch my channel, but it is structure loss. This is one of my, you know, biggest pet peeves ever. I hate when a bag, especially one that starts out really structured, gets really saggy or distressed as time goes on. I just really, really don't like that look. Now, it's different if the bag starts out distressed and like it's meant to look that way. You know, maybe like the Balenciaga City bag, if that bag is even relevant anymore. But, you know, a bag like that, it's meant to be saggy. So in that case, it doesn't bother me as much. But, you know, bags that I can think of that definitely show this tendency are maybe like the Louis Vuitton Capucines bag in the bigger sizes. It starts out really, really beautiful and really structured with like the crisp lines, and it just looks really great and boxy. But then over time, the sides start sagging, it starts collapsing into itself, and oh, that really, really bothers me. So whenever I'm doing research on a bag, especially ones that look really structured to begin with, I like to research, you know, what it looks like in a couple of years, what it looks like with heavy use. And normally the way that you can do that is just go onto pre-loved websites such as Fashion File and The Real Real. A lot of the times people are selling their bags if they've had them for many, many years, or, you know, if they've used them a lot and don't want them anymore. And you can, for the most part, always tell, you know, if a bag is going to hold up if you check out those websites. I always see like Capucines bags or like, you know, the Prada tote bags that were once really, really beautiful, now very, very saggy and just, you know, caved in. And I just, that just really bothers me. So yeah, I always make sure to do my research on whether or not the bag is going to last a long time and really keep its structure. I think obviously like bigger bags, you know, tend to lose the structure the most, but smaller bags can too. So yeah, I highly recommend, if that is one of your pet peeves as well, to make sure you do your research on wear and tear. All right, see, next thing I don't really talk about very often because it doesn't happen very often in bags, but I really don't like mixed metals. I don't know what it is, but I mean, it's probably actually because I only really like gold. I have maybe like one or two handbags with silver hardware, one of them being my Lady Dior right here. But you know, for the most part, I do enjoy the way silver looks. It's just, I have a harder time buying them and styling them, I think. So that is why I have a tendency to mainly seek out gold hardware handbags. But if it has both silver and gold, that just really bothers me for some reason. So the couple of bags that I can think about right now are the Chanel Gabrielle bag and the Chanel 19 bag. Those bags actually, I think, have a mixture of gold and silver, and maybe like the gunmetal silver as well. Yeah, it's just a lot going on, and I know a lot of people will say like, if it has a bunch of different metals, you know, you can match it easier because it doesn't really matter what kind of metal you're wearing in terms of accessories. But I just find that to be like the complete opposite. Maybe it's because my style like isn't edgy or trendy enough, but yeah, for some reason I just find that the mixed metal look is definitely not for me. So I would have to say that is definitely one of my other handbag pet peeves. All right, this next one is going to be kind of really, really specific, and I don't know if a lot of other people have this one, but I don't like having small tote bags. Now, I know this sounds really crazy, but so you know how like the Hermes Birkin is basically like a tote bag? It's one of those bags that looks like it's meant to be a work bag, but it also comes in smaller sizes. I think those smaller sizes are cute, but they don't really seem like they serve a purpose for me. I guess if you really like the look of the bag and you like having smaller bags in general, it makes sense, but bags like that look to me like they're supposed to be big and they're supposed to be work bags, so I don't like them when they're small. Another example is the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. It comes in a PM size, an MM size, and a GM size. I really like both the MM and GM, but the PM size just seems a little bit weird to me. Like, it's just so small. I think it's meant to be an everyday handbag, but it looks like it's supposed to be, you know, a bigger bag. Another bag that I can think of for this example is the Fenty Peekaboo and the LV Capucines bag. Now those ones come in many different sizes, but I think like the medium size or the larger sizes like look more normal. Now I know I was just saying the whole thing about the sagging of the Capucines bag, hence the catch 22 and the reason why I don't have any of these bags in my collection, but I do think that they look better in the larger sizes. I know this is totally my opinion and I'm sorry if this offends you if you disagree, but I like them in the more like medium to large sizes, and in the small sizes it just looks like, I don't know, a shrinking down version that just doesn't make any sense to me. So yeah, that is my opinion, but I totally feel strongly about this. Alright, another thing that really, really bothers me, and I think a lot of you guys will agree with me, is having a bag with an undetachable strap. Here is a good example. This is my YSL camera bag, and you cannot remove the strap in any way. If I do want to display it on my, you know, bookshelf back here, I have to tuck in the strap. And at that point, I can't even close the bag because the strap gets in the way. I just don't see the point of not having a detachable strap. I mean, it totally kills the versatility of the bag, and having a detachable strap is just so, so important to me. Especially when the strap is like this one, where it's not even a chain that you can easily tuck in. It's just so, so cumbersome, and I know I'm not going to be wearing this bag as a clutch or anything anyway, but I just like having the option of detaching it. Like, is that weird? I don't think it's weird. I think a lot of people will actually agree with me on this. It just makes the bag way, way more functional. And plus, because there is like a trend right now to mix and match straps or maybe buy a chunkier strap for your bag, I just think that it's really useful to be able to detach the old one so that you can maybe update the bag or, you know, buy a strap that actually fits you. A lot of the times with the straps that don't detach, they're always also an awkward size as well. This is my Givenchy Ansigona. I know they've already updated this so where you can detach it, but this was like the first generation where you could not, and yeah, this just doesn't make sense to me. Although I always say that I use this one very often, that is clearly my unpopular opinion, because every time I watch a video about this old Givenchy Ansigona, everybody always complains about the strap not being detachable. So yeah, I don't know why you would ever put a strap on a bag that you can't remove. Let me know in the comment section if you share my sentiment. Alright, and then the last thing that I'm going to be talking about is compartments in handbags. Now, I know that sounds kind of vague, but I actually hate when handbags are like pre-divided, although I do have a lot of handbags that are like this. But like I said in the beginning, I can handle it if it has like maybe one of these pet peeves on my list, but if it has like a few or more, yeah, that is where I draw the line. So what I'm talking about are bags like this where like it looks like a big bag, but then there are like compartments in it that restrict like the function and like how much you can put in the bag. Now I know a lot of people like compartments because of like organization, but I personally hate them, because imagine if this trendy CC bag was just like all one compartment and like this whole leather bit was just one and it wasn't divided into three sections. You could theoretically carry something that was like the width of this entire bag, but because it is divided into three compartments, the largest item that you can put in here is just the width of the largest compartment. I know that's kind of like nitpicking, but like I carry some bulky stuff sometimes, mainly my vlogging camera and my extra camera lens. They don't fit in bags like this because, you know, it's just too small, which is crazy because this bag doesn't look small. So that's like one of the things I really, really don't like about compartments. A lot of the times they'll put like compartments into like bigger tote work bags as well. An example that I can think of is maybe like the YSL Sac de Jour. I really love that bag, but I had one of those where you could not remove the divider compartment, and you know, if I do want to stick like maybe a file folder or a larger laptop in there, you could fit it in there if you could fit it diagonal, but because there is a compartment dividing in the middle, it kind of just like divides the capacity in half, and I really, really don't like that. Like I said, I know a lot of people do like this for organization, but to that I say just carry like pouches or something. Like, you can always organize your stuff into little pouches. You can, you know, buy those like cloth or plastic pouches for really, really cheap, like Target or whatever, and that basically basically solves your organization issue. So yeah, I just really don't like these compartments. I find them so restrictive. Another bag where it really bothers me is actually my Bulgari bag. Now I don't talk about this one a lot because I haven't really used it yet, but this bag, it looks really, really thick and really wide. Like if you measure the width, you're like, hey, that is a pretty big bag. But no, because the compartments are very, very, very small. Like I can barely fit my phone into one of these compartments, but if they didn't have these little dividers, I could easily fit my phone in like diagonally. Does that make sense? So yeah, that is why I just find compartments to be very, very annoying. Obviously, I do still have a lot of bags with these types of compartments and I kind of just deal with it, but boy, do they bother me sometimes. It's a wasted use of space and I would rather just not have them in my bags if I could choose. All right, so that is my list. What did you guys think of it? Let me know down below what is your handbag pet peeve. I could probably think of a lot more if I really sat down and thought about it, but I think those are the main ones that stick out to me. If you did like this video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Once again, I would like to remind you that my 10K giveaway is coming soon. I've ordered the item. I just have to film the video. So yeah, I'm so sorry it's been taking so long, but thank you so much for your patience and please, please, please subscribe so that you don't miss that video. And yeah, with that, thank you guys so much for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy out there, and I will see you next time. Bye!